Romanoff. I'm an actor from the States, and I was so excited when I was invited to speak with Subodh Gupta. I was thinking, what is the parallel, and why would they want an actor speaking with the sculptor? And I find that when I'm creating a character, I'm inspired by a movement of a hand, some way someone walks. It's always influenced by what's around me. And I find that your work is also influenced by what's around you and what you've grown up with. So that, I think, is our common ground. So as a wonder, you come from a small village, from Bihar, is that how you say it?
Mm-hmm.
And how do you think that's influenced you as an artist?
Well, I've spoken so many times about how I came to the art world. I think, but repeating again and again is quite boring for me, honestly. But I'm here with some of my artworks, again, to share with you. And can I begin with my slides and show them to artwork? And that's the best way to interact. And if you have, after that, any question, we will carry on from there. What I'm going to do here, again, last 20 years, I've done numbers of works, but here I'm selected only 10, 15 works to show you what is the very important to me, and I will go for that. And this is the first installation called 29 Mornings, and first time ever I made installation in my life, and that's why this piece is very important for me. And 29 mornings, I say, because there is a 29 partla in this works. And you see the details. This work is also very important for me when I came to Delhi first time. And when everybody, like we all know, Delhi is a political city, and people migrate from all over the state, and how they in the dialogue, they treated there. So obviously, people who come from Bengal, they call Bengali. People who come from Gujarat, they call Gujju. The people who come from Malayalam, they call Mallu. And people who come from Bihar, they call Bihari. But problem stuck with the Bihari. When you call them Bihari, Bihari, Bihari will feel very offended. Like, hey, like you're swearing to them, no? And I was always wondering why they, it's a kind of slang. And then I always wonder why I'm from Bihar and the people calling me Bihari, why the people get so offended about it. And so I made this works called Bihari, and I prominent myself, and that was the part of this whole hidden culture in Delhi. Then I made this piece called Cross Seven Seas. And Cross Seven Seas work, I made it first time. When the first time I would start traveling Europe, and I used to, buy the cheap ticket, I never used to get direct flight. I used to go stopover flight, like via Delhi to Kuwait, Kuwait to UK or Europe, any part of the world. Or Delhi to Dubai, Dubai to London, whatever. But very interesting part is, when you come, you go from Delhi to Dubai and Dubai to London or Europe, any part of the world, and the way you come back, Europe to Dubai or Kuwait, whole flight get empty. And then suddenly you say, okay, oh, what's happened? But nothing happened. Suddenly within 15 minutes, whole flight get full. And then you see, who are these people? And these people, nobody. These people, they're my own people. They're coming from the, but I start talking to them. And when I talking to them, I find out they are working for this city almost like 6 months, 2 years, 1 year. And after working a few months, a year, they're going back home. But when they're going back home, they're carrying the bundle like this. And that's intrigued me. That's how I made this work. The Cross Seven Seas. And their bundle is so interesting. I feel I will definitely, it will beat the Louis Vuitton and Gucci bundles when you will see their bundles. You can't open them, no? So beautifully tight, no? Beautiful textures of seats and the red nylon No, so it's a colorful as well, same time. So very interesting, and but same time, very emotional too. Because when you wonder what, I always wonder, what is this inside bandhan? But always curiosity about what is the inside, that was a more intrigue for me. And I find out what could be inside. And could be they're carrying the watches for the family, they're carrying the toy for their children, maybe some garment for their wife. So whatever they're carrying is not a matter, but whatever they're carrying is to matter for them a lot. They like they're carrying the dream. So I was very much, I did many series of that related, but I'm not showing you here, but only one big installation I'm showing you, the Cross Seven Seas. And then I made this work with the cinema. And cinema again is called, there is always cinema. And my gallery in San Gimignano in Italy is a small village. And the gallery converted, there used to be old theater, and the whole theater converted as a gallery space. So still there is like a whole atmosphere. There is a balcony, there is a stage where the seat is, they've taken the seat out to put artworks. So whole cinema structure is there, but they converted as a gallery. But it's so beautiful space. It's not such a white cube, typical gallery often you see around the world. So that gallery itself has so much character in it. And but one of the room of the gallery was closed. And I asked my colleague, Lorenzo, what is in this room? And he said, the equipments from the cinema, old cinema, they kept it. So I opened that room, and every single object I found it is kind of nostalgia in Bihar, where I grew up, and the railway colony, where also the cinema was existing. And cinema was the biggest part of the everyday life for their people in Bihar, too, to watching it, going everyday cinema. So that somehow connected me, and I made this work called There Is Always Cinema. So what I did, like you see, one of the object is black, one object is gold, brass. So the real one, I kept at it, and I casted the other piece, like looked like exactly bronze. And like you will see the details here. So this was, I did the many series with the There Is Always Cinema too. You can see that this is also part of the same. I kept the film, maybe it's the, some of them movie you like see, it's not Italy, maybe it's Fellini movie, but whatever, lots of excitement was there. This is the piece everybody knows called Very Hungry God. I made it in first time in Louis Blanc's in 2004 when I invited by Nicola Borio and Joram Shah to do this project. It's called White Night, where the artwork exhibited only for 12 hours. For 12 hours, making such a big piece was a challenge. It took me 3 months to create these works, but only exhibited for 12 hours in church that night, but given lots of opportunity to exhibit any part of many part of the world. This is a work called Aam Aadmi. Like you see the mango. This mango is casted in the bronze and painted exactly look like a mango. And I call this piece Aam Aadmi, like we all know, all the politicians in India when they call Aam Aadmi. And only mango is a fruit in India, you find, also reaches to the Aam Aadmi. And so contrast between the Aam and Aam Aadmi, Mango Man, this was really quite, I like to play with this idea and try to make this particular work. And that's how I made this work. And then I made the work called Gandhi Three's Monkey, how the Gandhi Three Monkeys, Bura Mat Sono, Bura Mat Dekho, Bura Mat Kaho. So how today in this world, if Gandhi could have lived, and there's so much violence, so much tragedy we're going through it, sometimes we don't know how to give our other cheek to slap someone. So in that way, a reaction of that, so what happened to Gandhi Three Monkey? So it's just an artist version. One become a terrorist, one become a chemical man, one become a military man. This is the work, again, I work with the utensils, kitchenwares many times. And like you see, take off a shoe and wash your hands. And given the title of this works. And I just exaggerate things sometimes to make my works. And this is one of them. Because if I put it single things, maybe I don't know how people reacted it. So I kind of, I completely taken over, I made the mural with that. This is the works called Black and White. So like I say, when I travel, when I see things, how the swastika, we in Hindu mythology, we pray and we quite good luck and many things. And how the Nazi used the swastika in many very different way. So that's why the same object can be has a two. One is black, one is white. I made it fan, and it moves slowly, slowly. The last work I made it called Itchu Duchamp. It's like I very much like Duchamp work. And it's not something I made it for many other reason, but only one reason, when I was in Tate Modern and watching the exhibition of Picabia, Man Ray, and Duchamp, and I was passing through, and when I come to the Duchamp, the Mona Lisa I scribble on the postcard, I was quite intrigued with that, and I feel like I wish Duchamp could have been alive, and I could have wrote him one postcard to him. And so this work, I made it in a 3D sculpture, and it's like writing one postcard to Duchamp, artist to artist. This is the work I made in the Lille for the India show, and where the many artists from India went there, and we all created different kind of works. But this is the place when they showed me. I was really very much excited and intrigued. It was a church, but church was not functioning. So many artists did the work there. And they showed me the first work, last work it was exhibiting over there, is Peter Greenway, and whom I admired so much, whom I respect so much. And so I got so nervous, I can't tell you, my God, after Peter Greenway, what I will do in this space. But I come out with this, and I made these works. And when I made these works, the Lille people liked it so much. The first work in my life, the collected by the mayor of Lille and become a now permanent installation in the Lille itself. This is the work I'm showing you purposely. India is such a huge country and we lack so many to see public art and public places. And this is the first time Bihar Chief Minister Nitish Kumar invited few artists and given the space to do in some artwork in the public. So I made this week's piece, Cactus in Bihar itself, permanent installation. So I feel very good about it. Also, I don't know how to mix with the design, art. Today I do find the canvas of art, visual art, or canvas of design, or canvas of architecture, it's become like one canvas. And it's so broader now, like a documentary filmmaker exhibiting in Documenta, Ramkula as an architect exhibiting in Venice Biennale. So you see that how the art we are coming in the one platform slowly, slowly. So for me, doesn't make so much difference, good design and good art. I find them same. And I have the same respect for the good design and good art. And when I saw the Donald Judge, one of the very famous artists, is no more, and when he designed furniture with art, so I'm just sharing you, some of them artists whom like their design. And I didn't bring so many artists, many artists did the many design works, but especially whom I liked very much, I wanted to share with you. So this is the work from Donald Judge, who made the chair, table, but it's very related to their artworks, same time. And I'm very fascinated with that, how they did it. And another very famous artist from Vienna, is no more, called Franz West. Franz West is one of the most avant-garde sculptor, one of the finest man, and he no need to talk about him. But he was also, as a designed so many furniture as an artist. So his furniture is like you see here, some of them I'm sharing with you. Sometime also I got each, okay, I want design too. So this is the lamp I designed in my studio, never exhibited anywhere, now is rusting. So you can see the close-up, but it still work. This is the chair also I designed this piece of artwork for me long time ago. So I thought I must share with you. This is the table also I designed it. Sometime, but I never exhibit. This table I'm using in my home. You can see the detail. Thali is ingraded in this fiberglass material. Yeah. Sometime I asked for the design jewelry for some charity. So I didn't design jewelry for any other things, for some charity auction for the benefit of the kids, handicapped kids, or cancer, or many other things. So I made some I did design the 2-3 jewelry I'm sharing with you. This is one of them. It's related with my art, but same time, this is jewelry. This is another jewelry already did it 3 years ago. Very tiny with lots of diamond inside. No? So, yeah. You can see the detail.
So I have a quick question. You didn't mention, I was wondering, we've got all these sculptures and the different furniture that you're designing, but recently you were asked by the Bolshoi Ballet to do a set for them. What was that like?
That was a great. Yes, wish I could have showed the slide, but I think it was performance here only in this theater 2 months ago. And it was great. So that's what I'm saying. Sometimes art and design and performance is part of one things. And that was the great experience. That was the phenomenal experience for me when I did this project with Anjuloka Porjakal. And I did this project 3 years ago. And when first time they give me the letter, I'm going to design the stage with the Bolshoi. And then I was no doubt a bit nervous because I thought, wow, it's a big thing. But when Anjuloka came to my studio in Delhi, and then we spoke about the theme of the theater, and everything began from there.
So it's more of a collaboration than you normally have.
One of the best collaboration ever did that, yeah.
Right, right. And so speaking of collaborations, you're also married to a famous artist. Do you guys speak about your work, or do you influence each other or give each other, that's okay, that's not so okay?
Fight a lot.
You fight.
Of course you live 2 persons together, you talk about art. You talk. She's my first audience for see any piece of artwork I create.
Right, right. Yeah. So that's nice, that's a plus, yeah, isn't it? So I was wondering, one other thing I want to ask, and then we'll ask questions from you. I was wondering, at what age did you know that you had to create? Was it something you knew that an artist was a job, or how did it happen for you?
I didn't know how it's going to begin, I don't know even art school. I don't know many other things. One thing I know what I like, and that I knew. And what is that called? I don't know. So I love watching objects. I love things and what I try to draw. And in that time, in 30 years ago, in any town, a small India town, you don't see so many visual arts except calendar arts, like God, Goddess, and all religious calendars. And yes, some of them, God and Goddess picture, I used to draw them because I like the form and just had to enjoy them. And that's how everything began, yeah. I don't know where I was going, but I think I was going right direction.
Right, and I think there's a through thread that other designers and architects and artists are speaking of is this curiosity that they've always had, curiosity of what is this going to be if I put this together? What is this going to be? It seems to be that as a child, that was your curiosity. What if I put this with this with this? Is that still with you today, the curiosity of what's around you and what can you make of anything?
No, it's tough. Yes, for an artist, I think for in one life, an artist too, it's not enough. Because you have so much thing to do, so many things to do. But problem is, when you change your direction and you want to try to do this, you want to try to do this, and you want to write, but you not actually, you puzzle yourself and puzzle the people too. Mm. So it's very much important to you focus what you're doing it and keep drawing in the same direction and then come up something nice. So that's the main idea. Yes, but lots of curiosity still, lot thing to do. Wish I could have done that, wish I could have done that. Mm. But what you do, what you do.
Right. If there's anyone who has questions.
Hi, it's me. I have a question. The stage production that you did with Ballet Par Collage, could you talk a little more about the process? Because how did it happen? Did the choreographer come to you first? Was the production done? And then she approached you, or how did the process?
No, production was not done. Not even, nothing was done. The choreographer came to my studio and then okay, we were going to work together. I'm going to go, what? How are we going to work together? And then he said, yes, I'm going to do some performance. Basically, the Bolshoi Theater always did the traditional dancing with the whatever come in there. That's why Bolshoi is famous for. Anjelovka Projekal team is contemporary dancer. In Aix-Provence, they're doing it. But first time, he invited by the Bolshoi or invented by the Bolshoi to do the contemporary dancing with the Bolshoi dancer as well as his dancer. Over there, he asked me to design the stage. But I never knew what going to be dance, what subject it is. But when Projekal came to my studio, he made many things clear to me. And yes, the first idea he given me, Apocalypse. So we start working on that. And then various idea comes. Many things we gone through. I went 2 times Aix-Provence to see the performance. Not the performance what we was going to do, because that time is not even came together. But what work he does. And he not came to just only see me, what I'm going to make the work for the particular for the Bolshoi, what he's going to do, what I do in my studio. So we both was looking totally different works, what nothing to do, the works what we're going to do. And everything begin from there. And then I try to understand him, who is he, then he tried to understand. And that's how everything began, yeah.
You made this artwork which you titled as Bihari. So obviously you're not afraid of your identity. So
I think nobody should be afraid of their own identity.
Okay.
I'm not either.
Okay. So considering that Bihar itself has a good amount of traditional arts, like maybe Madhubani or some other kinds of art forms, so did you ever feel the compulsion to integrate what those kinds of art forms into your work, or did you ever feel the weight of your culture influencing your work? Did you?
No, because I didn't know about it, honestly. I came to Delhi and seen more Madhubani art than when I was Bihar, then I seen it Madhubani art. And also, I must tell you one thing. We very rich with our heritage, but we very rich with our contemporary heritage too, what we neglect. So after 200 years, someone will see what we was doing today. And that's my job to create as an artist.
Where do you think the Indian market stands when it comes to accepting installation art as a form of advertising?
First of all, not a single visual art advertise in that manner, like advertisement. But definitely when we do have exhibition, we make the portfolio, we make the catalog, we make the invitation card, and it goes to those people who love art. But you're talking about advertisement of art? I don't know about it, honestly. And I don't see anybody did it before either, advertisement of art. Yeah, that's why, no. That make a sense? I don't know. Sorry?
Absolute, like how you've made an installation art for Absolute. Like in Louis Vuitton, how they have installations, just it could be anything.
That was the commission piece. When someone asked me, can you make a jewelry, I pay you this much money. And if money attract me, I'm okay, yes, I will do it for you.
All right, thank you.
As an artist, you perceive things and you have your perspective. You try to show this is your perspective. But do you try to influence change, create change or in the society through your work, you know? What is the change that you would like to see?
That's a good question. But I do believe in it because the beauty thing about the visual art is not written. It's only you seeing it. Even one child when see one piece of artworks and what you looking at a piece of artworks, will you ask the question of the mind of that child how and what the thinking? It could be totally bizarre. It could be totally different. And that is the strength of visual art. Every single individual have a right to look at the art in very own way. They can bring their own story. And the change that itself change happening while you're looking the piece of artworks. And that change stay with you. That change going to change our society, and that change going to change this world. And that is the power of art.
Subodh Gupta. Thank you.